Rum wouldn't piss on your gums if your teeth were on fire.
This is like kind of a funny story I found, and I don't know, I live in Texas, and it's like a fucking disaster down here. Apparently it's a disaster in New York as well, which isn't surprising because these people are a fucking disaster. I know it's like not allowed to be said in polite company that foreigners suck and third world immigrants like suck, and they just like, pretty much, like, if you're a working class person like me, all this means is that your wages are going to be lowered. I don't know. You're going to have to, like, you're going to have people come up to you all the time and be like, oh, you speak Spanish. You know, like, they just have this stupid fucking look on their face all the time, perpetual. I call it peasant face because that's what these people are. They're peasants. And I could point these people out and be like, peasant. Just by looking at their face. I don't have to hear them speak or anything. And they just walk around with this confused look on their face. Like childlike, almost. Or retarded, or inbred, or something. And they come from these countries where, like, the age of consent is 12. And they have, like, third-grade education, no skills. And they're like, we want better life. But they wouldn't say it in English, but either. I mean, if they do speak, that's how they do. Broken English, like, we want better life. And it's like, if you're an American working class person like me, this should piss you the fuck off. Like, yeah, all you get for them being here is like, yeah, they get better life, you get to compete with them for jobs. And I have to explain this all the fucking time because no one watches my videos. But so the labor market works like any other market, right? So what happens to a product or service that's in abundance in a market? And the answer is the cost of that product or service goes down, right? It gets cheaper because it's in abundance. And it works the same way for the labor market. So when you dump tens of millions of these third world peasants on our country, and you're a working class person like me, I get pissed off. And people are like, you're not allowed to be pissed off because they're people. No, fuck these people. Man, I live in their shitty neighborhoods. Shit. Man, and these people have huge families, dude. Like, our laws are so fucking retarded. Like, I'll get into that. In the story, there's this lady. She came here with her kids and her husband, and she was pregnant, and now they have a 20-day-year-old American citizen. But I just think that's retarded. First of all, birthright citizenship was never intended to apply to people in the country illegally. And it's just, like, this happens. But once you get, like, birthright citizenship, like, if you're just come here illegally, shit out a kid, your kid is now an American citizen, even though you're in the country illegally, when he turns 21, he could sponsor you and his entire extended family. And let me tell you about these extended families. What a joy they are. Like, you got a quinceañera going down on your block? Yeah, you're not going to find parking that night, homie. I don't care how big your street is. You're fucked, and you're gonna hear a bunch of shitty music all night. Oh my god, their music and their culture. And I don't care, dude, people are like, their culture is great. I'm like, I'm not a cultural relativist. If their culture was so great, they wouldn't fucking do this. And they wouldn't complain about Americans and Mexican shitty music. They're like, I want my English, I want my menu in Spanish. I'm like, yeah, welcome to my world, dude. Most of the people I interact with on a day-to-day basis are foreigners. This is annoying. I have to leave Texas. Like, Mandy, I'm leaving Texas in the next 6 months. I don't know where I'm going, but I'm fucking leaving. And, because these people, these peasant-faced, third-grade education, always walking around, perpetually confused look on their face. You don't speak Spanish. Yeah, that's what you get as a working-class person when these people are allowed in the country. Oh, and your wages get lowered. Because, yeah, again, it's just a larger pool of labor. And all of these people just fucking... Anyway, Adams went down there. He doesn't want these people coming to New York. But this is quite a funny story because, like, they're all like, I want to go to New York. I hear that's where they help us more than anyone else. And he's just like, God. But really, he wants that some of that $1.7 trillion. That's why he's fucking going down there, trying to pressure. But he'll probably get it, too. So smart on his part, you know. However, if you really thought this was a problem and your city's and state's resources were being, you know, taking in all these people, a homeless shelter. Dude, he spent like so much fucking money putting these people in homeless shelters. And I'm gonna show you a video after I go to this article about, yeah, the state of fucking these hotels, these motels in New York City, and these migrants, you know, getting drunk, punching a fucking security guard, having sex in the stairwell, you know, of course, things I would expect from these people, because I lived in their neighborhoods, dude. People fucking suck. These third world people, it's just like, there's like millions of them. Like, and they're just like, and they just openly say, like, I just come here for a better life. I want a better life. I want a better life.
Mexico now says about 100
like these entitled motherfuckers can't say I'm like people that like support this shit. They need to come down to Texas. They need to come to the southwestern United States. They don't know what the fuck they're talking about. Yeah, and New York ain't that bad, huh? But yet there are 39,000 people coming to New York. Like, so you advocate for like problems that you don't have to deal with the consequences of. But then when you do have to deal with the consequences of it, you're like, oh shit, we're overwhelmed, and our system is at a breaking point. Because, yeah, this is what you get when you actually take in the world's wretched masses. And that's what we got down here, folks, a shit show at the Texas border. The world's wretched masses are here, these new Americans, and they suck. Let me tell you.
Thousands of migrants here.
Migrants in El Paso, Texas, urge Mayor Eric Adams to take them back to the Big Apple with him on Sunday. You know that's like not what he wants to hear. He doesn't want it. These people to come to New York. It's like part of the whole point. He's fucking there. He's actually there to publicity stunt to get more money from the fucking federal government, which you probably get. And good on him. I mean, if you're just gonna allow all this craziness to stop, and you just are like, fuck it, just give me more money. You know, fuck the residents of New York, the homeless people of New York, and the, you know, just give me more money so I can take these people too, which is, seems like a shitty way to govern, but, you know, I'm not a Democrat. Adams was greeted by a crowd of curious onlookers during one of the stops at his weekend tour of El Paso, a center of the migrant crisis that has overwhelmed his own city. Yeah. Yeah, come down, dude. It's fucking a disaster down here. I see these people. It's just like, I heard they can help me in New York more than elsewhere. I heard the shelters are great there. Yeah, they are. I got a video for you. Was this Venezuelan Kaylee Marquez, one of the migrants gathered outside the Sacred Heart Catholic shelter. Some told the Post they wanted Adams to take me with you. That's fucking hilarious. Adams doesn't want to take you with him, dude. He doesn't want you in the city at all. No, he wants you to stay down here. So we can take, nah, fucking, what a disaster, dude. These people, they're just like entitled. They're just like, yeah, I want better life. I want shit given to me. I have a third grade education. I've got four kids and, yeah. Take me with you. Adams and his immigrant affairs commissioner, Emmanuel Castro, spoke to the asylum seekers after touring the church, which had opened its doors to migrants last month, as the border was overrun by those anticipating the expiration of Title 48. One man told Adams that he had heard about New York City by watching television, elicited a cheerful laugh from the mayor, who spoke to migrants as Castro. Yeah, they all wanted, they don't care, dude. These people come from like utter disaster fucking shitholes. And it's like, I don't care, dude. I think they should be pushed back across the Rio Grande. Like, I don't like these people. And people are like, that's fucked up. They're fleeing poverty and crime and war. I'm like, yeah, so what? They all say so they can come and work and drive down my wages. And shit, we got our own poverty, man. I don't like these foreigners to begin with. You speak Spanish. You speak Spanish. Oh, no, no, no. No, they can't stand these fucking people. I'm telling you, dude, peasant face is a fucking thing. You come down to Texas and you're going to see it. It's like, you just point these people out. Like, I could point out like an American dude that's Hispanic, you know, like he's American. He's cool. You see these fucking people? It's just like,
these people want better life.
They have this dumb look on their face.
Come in, drive over our wages, fuck over the taxpayers. You know, New York City
telling
you about all the resources they're having.
Northerners.
I thought.
Hell, I'm from up north too, dude. It's like a big culture shock to come down here and need a fucking translator everywhere you go.
And they're here long enough.
The mayor received a warm welcome from a group of dozens who raised their hands and burst into applause after he asked them if they had come to the U.S. to quote, work and experience the American dream. Yeah, that's all they want to do. So they're openly admitting that their asylum claims are bullshit.
So today,
or they're just here illegally and they don't give a fuck. Old you know, which is a good start, you know, not giving a fuck about the country you're migrating to. After you traveled to several fucking countries to get here, nah, you just go to the utter bullshit. Like, fuck these people, dude. These people are not asylum seekers. These people are fucking economic migrants. That what benefit are they going to bring to, I don't know, anyone that's an American citizen, and especially a working class American citizen? Nothing. You're going to have to work with them, not understand. They'll just be like, no English. And I'd be like, no English, okay. Which means what?
What was that trip
it's like? I don't know, dude.
You know that there's a
don't like foreigners. Anyone watch my videos, you know that. Like, now. I'm not fucking shy about it. I just don't like foreigners. I don't care where the fuck they're from. They're not Americans. Like, I just, I've lived in an area for like way too long. And it's just, we have to deal with so much bullshit from these people, dude. They come here, they don't know how to do anything, dude. I'm talking, they don't know how to use an ATM. They don't know how to pay for shit at the register. They don't know how to count money. Like these people are just fucking, it's like, who the hell let these people in the country? What benefit is the United States getting? Like, for its citizens, for the taxpayer, anything. So fucking, and nobody cares. You're supposed to be like, cheer this shit on. Yeah, diversity. No, fuck these people. This ain't even a diversity. This is just the same third world fucking. Sorry, man, I get worked up, you know. Pisses me off. Deal with this shit every day. I'm fucking moving, man, I'm telling you. Some migrants told the Post they were confused about why Adams was touring the border city. Because he wants to make a publicity stunt to try to get more money for New York City to deal with these fucking people. He said it was going to cost $1 billion. It's already cost $2 billion. It's like, yeah, what a disaster, Adams. Why don't you tell the president to fucking enforce the law and kick these fucking third world peasants out of the country? Like, push them back across Rio Grande, you know, fucking fly them back to Venezuela, wherever the hell they're from. But Venezuela won't even take them. That's the thing. These fucking shithole countries are fucked. And we're just getting shit on. Like that movie Scarface, remember? Like, we're getting shit on by Castro. Yeah, we're getting shit on by a lot more than that now. Not all these people. I want better life. I want better life. I want to bring my family. It's like, they don't see a problem with this. Because, of course, they benefit from this. The American people don't. The American taxpayer doesn't. The American worker doesn't. Fucking nobody does it. And the government, the Democrats, the enemies of the fucking Republic, the Democrats, they push this shit and they don't care. They're like, fuck you. Fuck your wages. Fuck your resources. These people want a better life. And it's just fucking sickening. Like, our government. Like, they don't care. They just don't give a shit at all. Like, I wish I could sit down and talk to, like, a younger Joe Biden, you know? Does he even know what he's doing? Does he even, like, fucking gone? But, and be like, dude, like, would you do this? And he'd probably be like, no, I'd never do such a thing. Whatever, dude. It just pissed me off. But it's funny, dude, because they all want to, they're like, take me with you, and all this shit. And he's, like, down there, because he doesn't want these people coming to his city. Yeah, they thought he was the president, maybe, because he had a six-car limousine motorcade. I hope his visit has the purpose of helping us, because we just want to get ahead in life. Yeah, again, just openly admitting that they're economic migrants. We're getting shit on. You're a working-class person. You should be fucking pissed about this. You should be fucking outraged. It's like, this is a, like, does your government have, like, a concentric circle of obligation where you come before foreign nationals? Clearly, your government doesn't give a fuck. Yeah, working class people, fuck you. Vote for us anyway, because we'll give you food stamps. It's like, fucking hate it. I don't use food stamps, like, but Marquez said she had given birth to the U.S. to a child who is now 20 day old. Oh, so she dropped shit out a kid as soon as she got here. And, like, yeah, she's going to be able, when that kid turns 21, she's not going to get deported, though. She's going to be like, you want to split up my familia? And she's going to go to the sanctuary. She'll probably go to New York. It's just like, what a shit show. So she shit out a kid, and that's how fucking dumb our laws are. Like, if you get, like, a green card, if you get citizenship, or you have a kid, 21, when that kid turns 21, he can, like, not just, like, I think it should be like, you can bring your wife and kids. Trump tried to change the law to make it like that. Didn't go anywhere, obviously. But it was just so retarded. It's like, that's our law. Like, you can't just bring your wife and kids, your, you know, nuclear family. You can bring your extended family, like sponsor them and they can get a green card, and then bring their extended family. And like I said, you live in one of these shitty neighborhoods, dude. You got a quinceañera on your street. You ain't finding a parking spot that night, dude. You go the street over. I don't care how big your street is, dude. It ain't gonna happen. These motherfuckers have huge families. Anyway, I don't know. Like, I sound like an asshole to a lot of people, and I understand that. But, like, I'm just telling you how I think. And this is, like, the reality of what's happening. I'm a working-class person. I don't like foreigners. I don't know why the hell anyone does. You ever lived in their neighborhoods? You ever fucking... It's like, I don't think you have. And a lot of people just advocate for shit they don't have to deal with the consequences of. And then, like, Mayor Adams, when it comes to his neck of the woods, he's like, whoa, 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 slow down, Governor of Colorado, Governor of Texas, Mayor of El Paso. Don't be sending these people here. He has to go down there and see firsthand. It's like, yeah, what bullshit. Two other migrants outside the church from Venezuela told the Post they wanted to read. they wanted to go to New York too. Of course. They knew it was a, I would like to go to sanctuary. Yeah, I want sanctuary. I want better life. Let me in. I want America too. When they give me citizenship, I want to vote to let my family come with me. It's like, no one wants to give you citizenship. I was reading some article, some fucking, these people don't know anything. They don't know anything about America. They don't know anything about fucking, they don't even speak English, let alone they don't come here for their love of Thomas Jefferson or fucking, you know, rights or anything like that, that like Americans would understand. It's like, these people are just a fucking train wreck with a third grade education from extremely corrupt cultures where pedophilia is legal. Like, yeah, like these are the new Americans that we're all just supposed to embrace, even though they fucking are costing us out the ass somehow, though. They're like that, they contribute, I guess. I mean, they don't, I mean, not in any way that like is a net positive for, I don't know, the treasury or any the American worker or anything. Anyway, another man specifically said he wanted to go to Queens, though he didn't explain why that borough. Okay. I want a work permit so that I can make a living. That's why we came here. Yeah, I just need a permit so I can go there and complete my reason for coming here. Yeah, the dude, tell that to an immigration judge. Can we just like quickly get that dude the fuck out of the country and reject his asylum claim? He said this. He's like, he didn't say he was fleeing persecution or the government was trying to kill him. He said, I'm come here to work and get a work permit and have a better life and send money back home, which is a thing too. They send money, fucking tens of billions of dollars, siphon it out of the U.S. economy to send back home every year, which is great, right? Adams toured the all-capacity shelter, which was filled with mostly illegal Venezuelan migrants and surrounded by people sleeping on the streets. Yeah, it fucking sucks. You need to get the fuck out of here, dude. These people need to get deported. These are bullshit asylum claims. Went through multiple fucking countries to get here. I'm talking about, I came here for a work permit. Yeah. The mayor, who's bussed thousands of migrants. Anyway, he met with the mayor. There's not really any good pictures of the migrants here. Because I always want to, like, look at their faces. Because I'm just like, yeah, these are the people. I know that's fucked up. People think I'm mean. And I am mean. Like, people think I'm nice and shit. And I am nice. Like, I don't talk to people like this generally. But I don't like this people. And I've been into politics since I was a fucking kid. And fuck it. Yeah. I'll ruin my life. Fucking because I'll say shit that is true. Or that I think. You know, whatever. This is my fucking YouTube channel.
So, video, Trump.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, he wants more. Yeah. Adams' visit came days after he projected the migrant crisis would cost New York City as much as $2 billion, twice what he had initially estimated. Ain't it a bitch? And then he's like, who wants to come to America for a better life? And they're all like, please take me with you to New York. It's just a funny situation. Where they're all like, yes, I want to go to New York. I hear they have the best shelters. And you know who else says they have the best shelters? This is a
bags of food being thrown away because the migrants don't want to eat them, and they just go waste. This is all food that's going to waste. This is insane. This is fresh.
So this is like a motel or a hotel in New York City that is only supposed to serve like these migrants. They don't have to pay anything. The city pays for it. And these entitled motherfuckers. I don't want that. I don't want that. I don't know. I just don't like these people. And this hotel that he's talking about sounds like a shit show. People having sex in the stairwell. You know, fucking fights and drunk fucking foreigners running in and punching security guards and getting fucked up. And yeah, sounds like a lot of fun. And I already know this, dude. I've lived in these people's neighborhoods. It's fucking chaos. People suck. Their culture is like fucking weird. Like, I noticed there was like no newspaper stands. It's like, this used to be newspaper, or there are newspaper stands like other places around the city. It's like,
this is good food. Good food, but they don't want to eat it. They said they don't like it.
Now, what you just saw is this huge amount of food that's been thrown away daily at this big New York City hotel that's being used to house illegal immigrants. Now, according to this whistleblower, more than 36,400 have come to New York City in the last few months, and city officials have put them in up in at least 14 hotels, one of them being The Row in Times Square. And that's where the pictures that you're seeing right now were taken. My next guest, Felipe Rodriguez, says that he's worked there since 2017, but now that illegals have taken it over, the place is complete chaos.
Yeah, dude. I already know. You speak Spanish. You speak Spanish. Like, these people, and it's just their face, too. It's like, I'm like, no, I don't. Like, what the fuck? Like, these people just, like, fucking suck. Like, people think that's mean, but it's like, you don't know them.
Now, when you say chaos, tell us what you mean. Fights, drugs, altercations, other violations.
Maybe if we just get enough of them, and they're here wrong.
Good
enough,
evening. Nice for you to have me. Thank you.
I highly fucking doubt it.
The,
so let's get into
the
it.
Chaos that we see at The Row today is compiled by migrants being drunk, drinking all day, smoking marijuana, consuming drugs, and domestic violence.
Yeah.
People having sex in the stairs, young people, teenagers, they use the fire exit stairs to go in there and do what teenagers do.
Yeah, they probably literally are like 12. It could be some dude fucking a 12-year-old. Like, I'm not even joking. Like, people think I, like, when I say that, I'm making it up now. The age you can sit down there is 12. Like, that's their culture.
People, you know, actually trying to the hotel is theirs and we have no rights.
Yeah, they do that with our entire fucking country. And for some reason, our leaders see this happening and allow it to continue, even though it's like a fucking disaster.
They don't clean it, they don't fold their clothes, they don't, I mean, it's in piles and piles, they're holding clothes, they're holding whatever they can hold, and there's no accountability. And when you go into a room and you say something, you know,
they'll be like, you speak Spanish, that's what they'll say. No, dude, like, I already know, man, and people are like, this is, fucked up. If you will. It's like they're not sending their best pro. They're really not. And like, there was advertisers leaving. We talked to Bob Iger. I do sound like an asshole, but I'm just telling you what I think.
What do you mean?
Being honest.
Management, especially the GM.
It's like, it okay not to like certain people, certain other cultures.
Practically, they have carte blanche. At the Row.
So Felipe, so you're what you'd say that is that you don't see this sort of expected gratitude for free housing, free food.
No, do they give a fuck?
Obviously, shelter in a city where rent is very expensive. You're not seeing a lot of that.
New Yorkers don't get that fucking. That's some bullshit.
There was a time in 2017 when.
But hey, New Yorkers, I'm just glad you're dealing with it now, too. Fuck y'all. You voted for this shit. Get a dose. This ain't nothing. $39,000. It ain't shit.
There was a lot of stuff that I had to be responsible for. Fortunately for the migrants, they got the government of the United States to hand them carte blanche to pretty much do as they wish. They go in and out of the hotel at will. You got people sick in there. They're spreading all type of illnesses. COVID, or you may have.
You say chicken pox?
And nobody is telling them they can't do that. So right now,
dude, like, I don't think he meant to say that.
The migrants, the hotel workers, lost their power at the hotel. GM doesn't have our back. I guess all he cares about is making the money that he's making. But
I don't want to turn this into a personal grievance about the GM or how the hotel is run. What we're interested in, Felipe,
it's not really.
So how did you find it? Oh, you didn't.
They found some weed in the hotel. Whatever. Yeah, but that's the state of our border today. And that's all I pretty much got to say on that. I just thought that was a funny article. Eric Adams going down to the border, trying to get more money from Biden. That's what happened. And he probably will. So, you know, I would say good on him. I mean, if that's his fucking goal, he'll probably get it. But I mean, really, I mean, we should just like not allow these obviously bullshit asylum seekers into the country. Like, I don't know how the hell we're supposed to take in. It's like our government thinks there's like 1 billion Americans south of the border. And on top of that, it's like the American public, poll after poll for a long ass time, is like, we want less immigration. We want less immigration. And doesn't matter if there's a Republican or a Democrat, nothing gets fucking done about it. Nothing. And it's like, why don't we have a point system like Canada? You know, I would be more like the Japanese model. Like, you ain't ever becoming a citizen. It's too late for that, right? Like, I mean, like the Japanese, if you're not Japanese, you ain't shit. And you can come, but you ain't staying. I would have like more like Mexico's model. There ain't no fucking birthright citizenship. Like, Mexico's immigration policy, I would rather have theirs than ours. Our policy is fucking retarded. You come here, you get citizenship, you get a green card, you could sponsor your entire fucking extended family. And these people have like 72 cousins and fucking aunts and uncles and sick elderly fuck. I mean, I see these people, I'm like, who the fuck let this person on the dialysis machine in the country at fucking 82? Don't speak no English. I'm like, huh? How's that make sense? But that's our country. It's a fucking joke. It pisses me off. And I'm a working class person. I don't like seeing millions and millions and millions more people being dumped in the labor market. And they're just like, I want better life. And they have a stupid look on their face. They don't speak any fucking English. They don't give a fuck about Thomas Jefferson or the Bill of Rights. None of that shit. They all come from fucking corrupt shitholes that they fucked up themselves. And then they flee here. And they don't assimilate. They don't give a fuck about becoming Americans. They're not Americans. I don't give a shit. They shit out anchor baby kid. That kid isn't even an American. His loyalty is going to be towards his family. You hear this all the time. Familia. Familia. It's like, God. So, fuck all this. And that's my 2 cents. Hey, New York. Anytime you see some New Yorker out there listening to my video. Anytime you see someone out there that has this like utterly retarded look on their face, like they don't know, like they're just like, and they're like, you ask them something and they're like, oh, you speak Spanish. Yeah, that's your new Americans that you voted for. Yeah, they suck. Anyway, with that, Have a wonderful day.
Look,
and I'll see you in the next video.
All of this bullshit. Birthright, thank citizenship. You. Like, our country, our government should have some fucking obligation to us. We shouldn't be... Tim Pool, he talks about, you know, Zoomers, like young people in this country. If you can even call this a country anymore. I don't really think you can call this a country. It's an economic zone for anyone that wants better life and fuck your American values and fuck, you know, the Constitution and all that shit. No, your government doesn't give a fuck. And people like this, Tim Pool often talks about how young people, right? You're supposed to inherit this great country. We stand on the shoulders of giants. These people that came before us made a truly amazing civilization and society in a great country. And we're destroying it, dude. We are handing over the inheritance of young Americans, young people, that should and deserve to inherit this country and all of it. And we're handing it over to pieces of shit like this. Look at this peasant face. I always like to look at their face. Look at this fucking retard. And he's got his American citizen kid. We just allow that too. Like, everything about this country, it's going down the tubes. It pisses me the fuck off. These losers, they come here and they're just allowed into the country. They just say, oh, asylum, and their bullshit asylum claims. This dude went through 12 countries to get to the United States. Like, 12. That's what he says. I think he's a dumbass with no education, so he can't count. Venezuela, it ain't 12 countries away, but... These people are... How does Tim Pool put it? The inheritance of our country is not being given to young Americans. It's being given to foreigners. Illegal, peasant-faced losers like L'Oreal. What kind of gay fucking name is that? L'Oreal? Is that how you say it? I'm probably butchering it. I don't care. I don't have respect for this person. This piece of shit. He comes here and he begs on the streets. He says that he begs and he gets $1,000 a week on top of the fucking $350 our government gives him. Like, I'm not even going to read the rest of this article. Should. Fuck. I, as an American that lives at Texas and sees these people all the time, and people will be like, this is fucked up. You know, these are people. No, dude, these people are peasant-faced foreigner losers that come here not because of their love of Thomas Jefferson. They come here because they want something from us. They are just fucking charity cases. I want better life. And they come here, they insult us. They tell... other foreigners to come here illegally and steal your property. Steal your property. And even then, the federal government doesn't do shit about it. They don't do shit about it. They're just like, well, you know, he. What does Joe Biden call these people? He calls them newcomers. Yeah, these Democrats. You get what you deserve, dude. These fucking Democrats. I hate these people, dude. These people want to destroy our country. I'm talking about Democrats. They hate you. They're like, we want higher wages for Americans, and then they're going to flood the labor market with tens of millions of these fucking peasant-faced losers that come here. Better life. I want to work. No education, no fucking nothing. Our country, like, you do understand, like, 100 years from now, Mexico is going to be Mexican. India is going to be Indian. Like, what do you think of the West? What do you think is going to look of the West 100 years from now? If we even make it 100 years from now. I'm talking like civil war will probably happen before all of this goes down. Like, the United States and Europe, and thank God for the Atlantic Ocean, because Europe has a lot worse than us. They're dealing with Muslims. And pick up a history book on the bloody borders of Islam. Whoa. The 1400-year jihad. Go look at how Constantinople turned into Istanbul. Like, that's way more dangerous. Like, I have more sympathy for Europe, but the goal... That these people, the Democrats, the left, they're pushing. 100 years from now, America and Europe, there's not going to be, like, any place that resembles what we had. What was given to us. And that's why I'm making this video. Like, people should speak out against this. Don't be afraid. Like, you have a responsibility. You stand on the shoulders of giants. Great men that built this great country and built the West that... For obvious reasons, everyone wants to come to. You know, it's the best society. It's the greatest culture and society and most technologically advanced because of us Westerners. And if you want to say Europeans, you want to put it in racial shit, whatever. I don't care.
Like, these people are not a good addition to the United States. These fucking losers, no education, come here for a better life. Like, our country shouldn't just be an economic zone that anyone is free to come into, and it should all we exist to, I don't know, love foreigners and boost the GDP. No. I guess I'll end the video here.